Hello dear students, a very warm good morning to all of you and welcome in our science period. So we are discussing our lesson that is changes around us. In the last video we have discussed about the reversible change, and in today's video we will discuss about the next point, that is nothing but what? Irreversible change. Okay, so ir means what? Irreversible. Okay, which is not reversible, which will not get back. Okay, means once the change will happen, from that the original substance, the original product, we will not get back at all. Okay, that is only what? Irreversible change. Irreversible change means what? Which never comes back, which never reverse. Okay, so that is about what? Irreversible change. So let's discuss about the definition. The change that cannot be reversed even by changing the conditions to obtain a substance back in its original form is called an irreversible change. Okay, so it is the change in that if we will change the condition, still we are not getting the original substance back, and that type of the change is called as what? Irreversible change. Okay, it means what? The original product or the original substance we are not getting back whenever, if we will try, but still we will not get the original substance back. If we change the condition, still we are not getting the original substance back, then that change is called as what? Irreversible change. Okay, so the change that cannot be reversed even by changing the conditions to obtain a substance back in its original form is called an irreversible change. Okay, so in it means what? If we will change the condition, still we are not getting a original substance back. If we will change, try to get the original product, then we are also not getting the original product back. Once the change happens, then we cannot change it again, or we cannot make it comes to its original form. Okay, that change is called as what? Irreversible change. So there are so many examples of the reversible change. We can say that the burning of paper, wood, coal, all these are what? The examples of irreversible change. Okay, why? Because once we will burn something, then that original product we are not getting back. Okay, also we can say that weathering of the rocks, aging of the living beings, okay, all these are what? The irreversible change. See, now our age is getting increased, but we will take it back, we'll go reverse, we can decrease our age? No, it means what? The aging of the living thing is also what? Irreversible change. Also the growth of the plant, growth of the living things, all these are what? Irreversible change. Also we can say the grinding of the grains into the flour. Okay, so if we grind the wheat grains into the flour, so from that flour we will not get that wheat grains back. Okay, or that whole grains we will not get back. That is only what? Irreversible change. Okay, so all these are the irreversible change in that original substance we are not getting back. Okay, so let's discuss the one example with the help of one experiment. Okay, so as we know that, or we are telling that, the burning of paper or the burning of coal is what? Irreversible change. So let's prove it with the help of an experiment. Okay, so see here, I have taken one lighted candle and I am having one paper. Okay, so see this paper, this is the one paper. Okay, so now I will burn this paper. Okay, see the paper is burning. Okay, and after burning, we'll get the original paper back. We are getting the original paper back? No. Okay, only we'll get the ash of the paper. Okay, means it means what? The burning of the paper will not get the original paper back. We are not getting the original paper back. We are just getting the ash of the paper like this. Okay, means it is not the original paper. Our paper was not like that, but we are getting the ash of the paper after the burning. So it means what? The burning of the paper is what? Or the burning of the anything is nothing but what? Irreversible change. Okay, so in your paper or in your textbook, in the table 6.1, there are the certain examples given that we will discuss whether it is reversible or irreversible. It can be reversed, yes or no. First one is there, raw egg to boiled egg. Okay, so raw egg to boiled egg, it is a reversible change? No, it is not a reversible change. So it will come as what? No, because from the boiled egg we will not get the raw egg back. So it is not reversible change. So you have to write no in that column. Next one is there, batter to idli. Okay, so batter to idli is what? Irreversible change. We cannot reverse that change. Okay, means from the idli we are getting again the batter. No, so the answer will come what? No. Next one is what? Wet clothes to dry clothes. Yes, it is a reverse change. If the clothes will get dry, then again we can wet it and again we can dry it. Okay, so it is what? Reversed change. So you have to write there yes. Next one is there, woolen yarn to kind sweater. Yes, it is also what? Reverse change. We can reverse it. Okay, so from that kind sweater, if we'll stretch it, then we can again get the yarn. Okay, or we can again get the thread. That is what? It is a reversed change. So you have to write there yes. Next one is there, ripening of the fruit. So obviously it is not a reverse change, so you have to write there no, because once the fruit get ripe, it will never get converted into the raw fruit again. Next one, grain to its floor. Already we have discussed that it is not it is a irreversible change. It means what? It will never comes back, it will not reverse. So you have to write there no, it is not reverse. No. Cold milk to hot milk. Yes, it is a reversed change. If the milk is hot, then we can make it cool. If the milk is cool, then we can make it hot. So it is what? Reversed change. Next one is what? Straight string to a coiled string. Yes, it is also there. If the string is straight, we can coil it, and if the coil string is there, then we can make it straight. So it is what? Reversed. Okay. Next one is that, bird to flower. Obviously the answer will come no. Milk to paneer. Yes, the answer will come what? No, because from the paneer we are not getting the milk back. Also we can say the next example, cow dung to biogas. So from the cow dung we are preparing the biogas, or we are getting the biogas, but from that biogas again we cannot make the cow dung. So it is what? Irreversible change. It means what? It is, it cannot get reversed. So the answer will come what? No. Stretch rubber band to its normal size. We have seen with the help of the experiment it is what? Reversed. So the answer will come what? Yes. And the melting of ice cream is what? Yes, that you know very well. Once the ice cream will get melt, it will keep in the freezer, then again it will get freeze. Okay, it means what? It is a reversed. So you can say right here yes. Okay, so these are the different examples. Among that, some are the reversible change, some are what? Irreversible change. To get to know very properly, you have to perform one activity at the home. That is activity number 2 from the page 49. That what is the activity? To study the formation of the curd, okay, with the help of the warm water. So for that, what you have to do? You have to take one warm water or warm milk. In that warm milk you have to add the 1 spoon of the curd, okay, and you have to keep it aside for 4 to 5 hours. And after the 4 to 5 hours, what you can say that the milk is getting converted into the curd, and its taste is also slightly getting changed. It becomes sour in the taste. Okay, so from the milk we can make the curd, but from the curd we can make the milk back? No, we will not get the original milk back with the help of the curd. So it means what? The curdling of the milk, it is what? Irreversible change. Or the formation of the curd from milk is what? It is an irreversible change. So this activity you have to perform at home. We will meet in the next video, and for today, thank you.